So good noon to one and all present here. This was a study on prophylactic anterior retinal cryopexy in patients who underwent primary vitrectomy in a proliferative diabetic retinopathy. How to go about the next one? Just enter. So past planar vitrectomy becomes the mainstay of management for any complications due to PDR. So vitrectomy is usually combined with a pan-retinal endolaser. Even after that, there are complications which occur that are anterior segment neovascularization. The past planar vitrectomy anterior segment neovascularization indicates that there is a persistent of retinal ischemia and non-perfusion. So anterior retinal cryopexy is helpful in treating the peripheral retinal ischemic areas and thus preventing the neovascularization and its complication. The purpose of this study was to find out the incidence of the neovascularization of iris, angles, and neovascular glaucoma, and to find out the peripheral port-related retinal breaks and the incidence of anterior hyoidal fibrovascular proliferation. So this was a prospective interventional non-comparative study, and the study period was between 2013 and 2015. A detailed history and a one-year follow-up was conducted for all patients. So the inclusion criteria was all patients who had PDR with fractional or agmatogenous RD with a non-dissolving vitreous hemorrhage, who underwent past planar vitrectomy along with anterior retinal cryopexy. All patients who had anterior segment neovascularization pre-existing were excluded from this study. So the procedure was to apply a single row of transconjunctival 13 to 16 confluent retinal spots, each for a duration lasting for 12 seconds, which was 8 millimeter from the limbus. So after ARC was done, all patients underwent the routine vitrectomy with or without endolaser, fluid air exchange, and with or without silicone oil, which was done according to the patient's need. And the results were, out of the 45 eyes, only 36 patients completed the one-year follow-up, and 4 eyes developed NVI at the end of one-year follow-up, and 1 eye developed neovascularization of angle, and 3 eyes developed neovascular glaucoma at the end of one-year follow-up. So this was just to find the incidence of the neovascularization at the end of one-year follow-up, and it was not a comparative study, and this was the drawback of this study as well. The incidence of NVI was 11% and NVA was 2.7% and NVG was 8.33% respectively. However, no eyes in our study developed the anterior hyoidal fibrovascular proliferation, which is actually a very less incidence, about 1 to 7% only, but still these eyes have a very bad prognosis once they develop this anterior hyoidal fibrovascular proliferation. However, in our study, we found that no eyes developed the anterior hyoidal fibrovascular proliferation or the port-related retinal breaks. However, further randomized control studies with large sample size are necessary. This was the comparative data which was compared to the studies which did only past planar vitrectomy and laser photocoagulation versus our study which combined the anterior retinal cryopexy as well. So there were no incidences of, the incidences were comparable, but since this is a small study, it needs a large randomized control study to validate the procedure as well. So to conclude, the prophylactic anterior retinal cryopexy along with the primary past planar vitrectomy might be an useful anchor in controlling the anterior segment neovascularization and its complications like neovascular glaucoma, and it is also helpful in preventing the port-related retinal breaks and anterior hyoidal fibrovascular proliferation as well. I thank the judges and the AOSC organizers for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.